Welcome! In today's video, I will be explaining a science fiction story called Metalhead from the popular Netflix series Black Mirror. Be warned though, there are spoilers ahead. From the start of this episode, it is obvious that there is something unsettling about the environment. The ominous expression on the faces of the three characters we see add to the grimness of the black and white setting, making it seem as though we are peering into a monochrome hellscape. As the story progresses, it becomes clear that it takes place in a post-apocalyptic world where artificial intelligence has taken over. We immediately descend into this post-apocalyptic future. The expressions on the faces of Bella, Clark, and Anthony suggest an apathy that is the result of extended periods of weariness. They drive past a farm and have a short conversation about how pigs roamed there in the past. Though it is not stated, we can be sure that whatever drove society to the ground is also responsible for the disappearance of the pigs. It's a rather unsettling thought. Life, it seems, has almost been totally erased from this barren landscape. The air is heavy with the traces of mass extinction. Unlike similar stories, little is known about the world where this story takes place. One thing is sure though, humans living in this world are under a constant threat of attack from highly intelligent robot dogs that hunt and kill humans for reasons unclear to us. The dogs are equipped with effective tools that enable them to track down and kill humans. Survivors in this world are forced to scavenge for food and other supplies. They stop at a warehouse that they have concluded is dog-free and attempt to retrieve a box that is presumably filled with supplies. What makes these dogs so especially frightening is their menacing silence. They have no desire, no emotion, just a simple goal that they perform mindlessly. In a grim setting, Bella, Clark, and Anthony drive to a warehouse in search for something to help Jack, who is hurt and dying. Anthony and Bella break into the warehouse while Clark hotwires a van. They scour through the warehouse before finding the box they have been searching for. A problem arises when they realize that there is a four-legged robotic guard dog waiting behind the box. The seemingly harmless dog suddenly sprays Anthony and Bella with shrapnel that contains a tracking device, and then shoots and kills Anthony. Bella attempts to escape, leaving the box behind and running straight for the car. Clark attempts to follow in the van, but before he can get away, the robotic dog leaps into the van and kills Clark, before continuing in its pursuit of Bella. Eventually, the dog manages to get into her car, but before it can kill her, she sends the car off a cliff and manages to escape. Bella thinks quickly and uses a plier to remove the trackers that the dog embedded in her leg. She makes a call to someone, telling them to pass a message to her loved ones in the event of her demise. The dog continues to pursue Bella relentlessly. It chases her into a nearby forest, forcing her to climb a tree to both escape the dog and rest. Fortunately for Bella, the dog damaged its forelimb during the car wreck and is unable to climb a tree. Rather than leave though, the dog decides to wait for Bella to get down from the tree, choosing to power down in order to conserve power. Bella throws a twig at it, making it power up and down. This eventually drains the dog of its power, and it stops responding. Convinced that the battery is dead, Bella climbs down and breaks into the nearest compound, but she knows she can't keep the dog down for long. The dogs are perfectly designed in both form and function. They are wired to kill humans and perfectly equipped to do so. Their minimalistic design conceals tools and weapons that enabled them to perform their function swiftly and mercilessly. And whenever their power dies, it only takes daylight to rouse them. Bella finds two rotting corpses in the bedroom and takes the car keys and a shotgun from the room. Once it's morning, the dog is able to recharge and it enters the compound, continuing its hunt. As the dog approaches, Bella ambushes the dog and throws paint over its visual sensor. She then throws the paint can across the room really hard so that it lands with a thud and distracts the dog, who now has to rely on its hearing. Bella uses this opportunity to escape. She runs for the car, but it won't start. She continues to try to start the car, getting increasingly desperate with each passing second. Eventually, she is forced to give up, and in another distraction attempt, Bella turns on the car radio and hides. Attracted by the radio's noise, the dog approaches the car, cautious and alert. As soon as the dog gets close, Bella shoots it. The dog fights back and manages to stab Bella in her leg, but she shoots it once more. Just as the dog drops to the ground, supposedly dead, it releases an airburst shell that sprays Bella with tracking embedded shrapnel. Bella re-enters the building and heads for the bathroom mirror to get a good look at the trackers that the dog sprayed on her face. She notices a lot of trackers, and in what seems like an act of desperation, she lifts a knife to her face, but stops as she realizes there's a tracker embedded in her jugular vein. Realizing her fate, Bella speaks into her walkie-talkie, saying goodbye to her loved ones, all the time unsure whether the message will ever get passed along. She picks up a knife and places its blade on her throat. Before the inevitable occurs, the camera pans out over the landscape and shows a group of robot dogs swarming towards her location. Finally, we are back at the warehouse. The contents of the box have spilt over and is revealed to have been filled with dozens of teddy bears. That becomes all the more clear when we learn that the item our trio was scavenging from the warehouse, revealed only in the episode's final shot, was meant to make the final few days of a child's life more bearable. Bella is collecting the teddy bear for a young relative after all.